Okay, this is going to be a re-review on my IZH-18MH single barrel hunting gun. And this is the instruction manual, as you can see. I'll just go over a little bit of the stats on it. This is the rifle version. They build a shotgun, basically the same action, like a break-open kind of shotgun kind of thing. And it has a booklet it comes with, has a list of the calibers, if the camera will focus on them. There we go. So you got 222 Remington, which is that's the other one I have of the two. 223 Remington, 243, 270, 76239, 308, 762x54, which is this one, and 30-06 Springfield. They also come like 8mm rimmed, 22 Hornet. How were the other ones? Like 9x53, which is like same like you're rushing around with a bigger bullet. I think 9.3x74 RAM. Like it was. Some of them are listed on the boxes that they came in, but they're not listed. I didn't really see them on the internet, on their website or anything. So maybe they don't import those versions to Canada. But it would be nice to have a 9.3x74. But anyway, it's got a 600mm barrel, so that's 60 centimeters, so that's about 24 inches or so. Its weight is 3.2 kilograms, so you're talking just over 6 pounds or so. And it talks about accuracy. It says it was test fired, 4 shot group at 100 meters, 70 millimeters, so 7 centimeters, so it's at 3-inch group or something at 100 yards from center to center, so that's not really bad, I guess. It says it depends on ammunition, too, if your ammunition's good quality. I mean, this one's shot quite well, though. At 25 yards, it'll shoot, like, one whole group, but trigger's kind of grotesque on it, so it kind of hurts it. But, anyway, there's the 762x54 round that it fires. Same as rounds like the Mosin-Nagant and some other Russian guns. I picked this round because it being a rim round works a hell of a lot better in a single shot rifle than the 30-06 and 308 are pretty much the same, but they're rimless. And I'll talk about that. You can see here how the extractor works, just like most shotguns or break open shotguns, it's similar. There's a little piece cut out of it that holds the rim. It slides in and holds it quite well, has a good grip on it. The rimless rounds, it has this piece, but it's got a little spring-loaded bit that sticks up in the middle. And as you push the shell in, it just pushes it out of the way, and then until it gets to where the extractor groove is, and then it pops up and grabs it. But this seems kind of flimsy to me, but my 222 is like that, but I haven't had any trouble with it, but it just seems like it's asking for trouble, so I kind of like that. Especially if you're dealing with the really, really high pressure rounds. Start getting at 308 and stuff like that. I don't know if you have extraction troubles with it or not. So I'll just go over, that's pretty much all I need to go over on the book. The book just basically the rest of it just talks about maintenance, disassembly, has a parts list, shows it all, like an exploded picture of it kind of deal. So I'll just go over the different features of it. It's pretty much a conventional, like, looks similar to most break-open type shotguns or whatever, but it has sights on it because it's a rifle. The front sight on this one has got the post, or the blade is on a pin. There's a spring under the front of it and like a nut on a bolt that goes up and down. And you just squeeze the blade in or out, or if you push this down, then you can turn it down or up, and the spring will push the front sight up or down, so you can get your elevation on it. You got your more of a North American style sling swivel on this one. This is a newer built one, I think. It's got like an inch wide. You can put an inch wide sling. The other ones were the narrower European kind of ones, and you sort of need those sling swivel, or the slings with the it's like canvas with the little leather belt thing on the end with the buckle. I had to put on those. Back sight's just a square notch, has a little screw there to lock it, and you just loosen the screw and you can move the sight for windage back and forth. And you got this big dovetail thing going on here on top of the chamber. It's like a 10 or 11 millimeter, I forget which one it is, but they have their special bases that go on here. I had one, but it was wouldn't stay, so I kind of gave up on it. And so you kind of need a steel type of base to go onto it, or ring. Because the one I had was aluminum, and it would move forward and kind of beat itself up. So you get your caliber list on the side. You got Baykal, the model, and made in Russia. And you got the trigger guards, like sort of a plastic stuff, a composite of some sort. You got your safety is right. Sort of shotgun kind of safety, just push it back and forth. Your opening levers here. You got a cocking indicator here, it sticks up when it's cocked. When it's fired, it'll go back down in. The stock on this one's birch, I believe. They come in beech as well. There's another sling swivel here. Recoil pad, which works quite well. Especially with the more powerful rifle rounds, that's really handy. The earlier ones, I think, just had the little plastic Bakelite one on there, and this gun wouldn't be too friendly, I don't think, since it only weighs just around 6 pounds or whatever, so I can probably feel it. But, I like the Russian round, but I kind of don't like putting up with the safety on the Mosin-Nagant rifle for hunting. Some of them either they're hard to take off or they're noisy or whatever. So this one's a whole lot better for just a tree stand hunting or dragging around. I think they're quite common, like in Russia they use them a lot. But if you could get a couple of these rifles, whatever calibers you like, and then shotgun version, and basically that's all you'd really need for most hunting situations. But still, that's no fun having just two or three guns to do everything with. But anyways, thanks for watching, and if any questions, just put in the comments there.